Welcome to the module of the What Works Clearinghouse WWC Single Case Design Standards Training, focused on outcomes measures and confounding factors. This module focuses on the WWC standards related to outcome measures and confounding factors for single case design studies. The objectives of this module are to describe the WWC outcome requirements, describe a confounding factor, demonstrate examples of confounding factors in single case designs, and finally, to describe how outcome requirements and confounding factors can affect a findings research rating. Let us begin by defining what the WWC means by an outcome. An outcome is the knowledge, skills, attitudes, behaviors, or other measurable characteristics that researchers measure to learn about the impact of an intervention. As discussed in the previous module of this training, studies that compare repeatedly measured outcomes from units before and after the receipt of an intervention are eligible for WWC review as a single case design study. An outcome measure is an instrument, device, or method that provides data on the outcome of interest. Impact evaluations use outcome measures to estimate the effect of the intervention. An outcome domain is a group of closely related outcomes. The study review protocol describes eligible outcomes and domains for WWC reviews. Researchers might examine more than one outcome measure in a study. So how does the WWC determine which outcomes to review? Well, the WWC applies an outcome measure standard to determine whether the measures used to estimate the effect of the intervention are credible. Let's start with an overview of the WWC's outcome measure requirements, which we then discuss in more detail in this module. First, the outcome measure must have face validity. That is, it must measure what it claims to be measuring. Second, the outcome measure must have sufficient reliability. That is, it must produce the same types of scores if it is administered or measured by different people. In single case designs, this requirement of reliability is usually met based on interassessor agreement data. In the rare event that an outcome in a single case design study is not some form of direct observation of behavior, and instead uses some standardized measure, such as a reading assessment, then reviewers can assess reliability for these outcomes in the same way that they do when reviewing a group design study. Third, the outcome measure must avoid overalignment with the intervention. When an outcome measure is closely aligned or tailored to an intervention, the study findings may not be an accurate indication of the effect of the intervention. Fourth, the outcome measure must use consistent data collection procedures for the intervention and comparison conditions. Namely, did the researchers collect data for the measure in the same way for both the baseline and treatment phases? Any difference in the outcome measure between the baseline and treatment phases should relate only to the intervention and not to the measurement process or the measure itself. Now, let's consider each of the outcome measurement requirements in turn. First, let's examine the concept of face validity. An outcome measure must capture what it claims to measure for the study to appropriately label the intervention's effect on an outcome of interest. The WWC says that an outcome measure has face validity when it has a clear definition and captures what it claims to measure. When assessing face validity, the WWC requires alignment between the description of the measure and the content of the measure. For example, if a measure is called a math achievement test, does it measure students' math knowledge and skills? If an outcome measure does not have face validity, then differences in outcomes between the conditions do not provide information about what it claims to measure. Any finding based on that outcome measure will receive a research rating of does not meet WWC standards. Next, let's consider reliability in single case designs. In the context of single case designs, the most common form of reliability is interassessor agreement. The WWC has special requirements for interassessor agreement, described in the section of the handbook that covers single case designs. The interassessor agreement requirements state that each outcome variable must be measured systematically over time by more than one assessor. Three criteria must be met for a single case design study to meet this requirement. First, study authors must collect interassessor agreement data at least once in each phase of a design. Second, the study authors must collect interassessor agreement data for at least 20% of the data points in the entire design. This is new under version 5.0 of the handbook. After reviewing studies under the version 4.1 handbook, the WWC determined that many high-quality, single-case design studies report interassessor agreement overall, or by case, but rarely report it separately by condition. The new interassessor agreement requirements now only require that authors report overall interassessor agreement for the entire design, rather than separately by conditions within the design. Third, the interassessor agreement data must meet minimal acceptable thresholds. The WWC currently defines those minimal acceptable thresholds as greater than or equal to 0.8 for percentage agreement measures, or greater than or equal to 0.6 for Cohen's Kappa agreement measures. There are a few important clarifications regarding this interassessor agreement requirement that deserve mention. As outlined in the WWC handbook, the interassessor agreement data must meet those minimal acceptable thresholds separately for each outcome measure across all phases and all cases in the design. But the interassessor agreement data do not need to meet those minimum thresholds separately for each case or separately for each phase in the design. If it is unclear whether this interassessor agreement requirement is met and the study would otherwise meet WWC single case design standards, reviewers will draft an author query to request additional clarification. The WWC submits author queries to request missing or incomplete information that could change a study's final WWC research rating. Next, the WWC's outcome requirements state that outcomes must avoid overalignment with the baseline or treatment conditions. So, what do we mean by overalignment? Overalignment occurs when a study closely tailors a measure to a condition, or the measure repeats some aspect of a condition. If a study closely aligns or tailors outcome measures to the intervention condition, the study findings may not accurately indicate the effect of the intervention. Let's walk through an example. Consider a single case design study where an interventionist teaches students a set of self-monitoring steps to improve time on task. Say the researcher was conducting a treatment reversal withdrawal design where they then record the number of steps performed correctly during each baseline and treatment phase in the design. The outcome of time on task is operationally defined as the number of steps performed correctly, rather than time on task. This outcome measure does not provide a fair test of the intervention condition because it is over-aligned with the intervention providing self-monitoring steps to students. A comparison of the number of steps performed correctly across baseline and treatment phases may provide an unrealistically favorable assessment of the effect of the intervention. So, if a study uses an overaligned outcome measure, the WWC will rate findings from all analyses that use the measure as does not meet WWC standards. However, this rule does not apply if material covered by an outcome measure must be explicitly taught. For example, imagine that the goal of an intervention is to teach functional skills such as hand washing. The WWC would not consider this measure over-aligned in situations where teaching young children to wash their hands a developmentally appropriate component of the intervention. When reviewing single case designs, this exception may come up more often than in group designs, because the outcome are often the direct observation of behavior. The last outcome measurement requirement is that the study must collect the outcome measure in the same manner for the baseline and treatment conditions to ensure that any reported intervention effects resulted from introduction of the treatment and not from data collection differences. If the mode of data collection differs across conditions within the design, then the difference in the outcome across conditions could be attributable to something related to the outcome measure itself and not just the intervention. If a study collects outcome measures differently by condition, the WWC rates the findings as does not meet WWC standards. Finally, a new outcome measure requirement in the 5.0 handbook is the requirement of measure independence. The study review protocol specifies that some outcomes may also have a requirement that the outcome measure be independent of the intervention. The WWC considers an outcome measure non-independent if it was developed by the study authors and is not in broader use, or if it was developed by the intervention's developers. For some outcome domains, findings based on non-independent measures cannot be designated as main findings for individual study reviews. For additional information about measure independence, consult Module 4 of the Group Design Training. Let's pause for a knowledge check to test your understanding of the special reliability requirements for single case designs. In a multiple probe design with 3 participants and 5 observations per phase, the author states, in total, across all 3 participants, 5 of 15 observations in the baseline condition and 2 of 15 observations in the treatment condition were independently double-coded. Coders were graduate students who observed the participants. Reliability was checked using Cohen's Kappa with an agreement of 0.7. Does this study meet the Interassessor Agreement requirements? Your choices are A, yes, or B, no. You may want to pause the video now to think about your answer. The correct answer is B. In this scenario, the researchers collected Interassessor Agreement, or IAA, data in each phase and in each condition, and the Cohen's Kappa value of 0.7 was larger than the minimum threshold value of 0.6. Overall, 7 out of 30, or 23%, of the data points had Interassessor Agreement data. However, because only 2 data points in the intervention condition had reliability data, only 2 of the 3 cases could have had reliability data for their intervention phase. Therefore, this study does not meet the Interassessor Agreement requirements. As a consequence, the highest possible research rating from the study findings would be does not meet WWC standards.